Well, it is time to get the Subaru back to 100%. So we basically rebuilt this whole car, got it as a project, rebuilt the whole thing, had a couple little small issues here and there that we were working out. As we were getting those sorted out, we broke the trans. I put another trans in it. Then we finally got it tuned because it never ran right. It ran great, so much better. We took it to the track and then broke some more stuff. So super simple stuff, some exhaust stuff. Let me get it in the shop and I'll explain more. Now that we got this thing up on the lift, I can kind of show you guys what is wrong. Oh, we need a light. So this is the turbo manifold header, whatever you want to call it. It's kind of a cross. Normally a turbo manifold is kind of short, but this is basically like a header that goes around. They join up here, they go through this flex joint, and then they go up to the turbo. Well, this flex joint is exploded. So that happened while we were at the track. So because that blew out, we had a massive exhaust leak. So what was happening is the exhaust gas that was supposed to be going up and spinning the turbo to make boost was just kind of bypassing it and coming out here. So that gave us two problems. One, it kind of screwed with everything because, you know, at a certain point in the RPM range, the car should be making a certain amount of boost and it's not. So the tune kind of gets a little wonky. And then on top of that, it makes it a lot laggier because we're losing a lot of the exhaust gas that should be spooling the turbo. Before we even noticed that though, when we were tuning the car and everything, we noticed that the car was a little laggy. You know, my tuner is adding a bunch of duty cycle in the boost controller to kind of keep the wastegate closed in the mid range to bring the boost up. And it would get to about 10 pounds and then it would kind of stay there until about 5,000 and it would ramp up to 18. Whereas, you know, when it hits 10, it really should go straight through to 18. So I'm assuming that that's been leaking for a while and that that is our problem. Other thing we want to deal with today is the exhaust. So I made this exhaust myself. I ended up buying a downpipe because I couldn't get the right flange set up for the turbo. So I just bought a whole downpipe and then I built the exhaust from there all the way out. One, spy cut tip looks terrible. Didn't do a great job pie cutting it and it just doesn't look right on this car, especially in the size in 3 inch. It doesn't suit it. Two, I put a resonator in, but the car is still obnoxious as hell. It's super raspy, it just doesn't sound good. It's like really loud, but also doesn't sound good. I'm okay with like my LS Miata is loud, but it sounds good to me. This car is loud and doesn't sound good. So we need to fix that. We also need to add a flex joint in here because we have no flex joint. If you don't have a flex joint in your exhaust, especially with a turbo car, the exhaust is gonna get real hot, cool down, real hot, cool down. It's really easy to crack it somewhere, you know, because there's nowhere for everything to flex. So instead of flexing, it'll crack. So that is also something we need to do. So we have placement flex joint for the one that blew out. And then we have two flex joints for the rest of the exhaust. I'm probably only gonna use one, might use two. I'm not 100% sure. We'll kind of see how it lays out. Oh, and then the muffler. Let me show you that. So I got this big, giant muffler. Sweet neochrome tip. I couldn't find one without it, but I decided to go huge on the muffler because I would rather it be too quiet than still too loud because it is super obnoxious right now. So massive muffler, let's figure out how to get that up in there and redo that part of the exhaust to make it all work with the flex joint and whatever. But first, we need to fix what's actually broken, not what we just want to improve. We need to pull that thing out, that whole header assembly. So it should be pretty easy getting it off the heads. The hard part is gonna be getting it off the turbo. It's kind of way up there and yeah. So anyway, let's dive right in. All right, I got the turbo bolts out, the bolts, you know, where the turbo bolts to the flange up there. Not bad at all. They were a lot easier than I thought. I was able to get an impact on all of them. Pretty much a miracle. So now we just got to get the bolts or bolts to the heads here and snake it on out. Leave the easy one for last. Just gotta get this O2 sensor off that I totally forgot about. Oh, you can see how broken this was. Jeez. There's your problem. Man, I was measuring this in a tight spot and I did not expect it to turn out to be pretty much dead on. In the camera, for some reason, it looks bigger, but I guess I have it kind of offset. You know, edge of the flange to edge of the flange, dead on. So really glad that worked out. Hopefully the diameter is right. It looks a little small, but we'll find out. So I went ahead and put some timing marks on this. So I've got, you know, one in the middle, two on the sides. That way, hopefully I can cut this out and then I can weld, tack this in. You know, I'll do this all on the bench, test fit it. It fits right first try, and then we can weld it out. That would make my life easy, but I'll have to take it back out and in a bunch of times. But man, look at how, I mean, like, come on, dude, that's crazy. No wonder this thing was a little laggy. I mean, you think that could have something to do with it? That is wild, man. The only downfall here, I mean, it's a good thing because it should be a lot more responsive, but the downfall is basically the boost control might be turned up too high now in the mid-range and it might over-boost because basically it was set at that level while there was a massive exhaust leak. But who knows? We'll find out once we get this back together and get it tuned and we go take it for a rip at the end of this video. So before then, no need to speculate. Let's fix it. All right, we got everything cleaned up and ready to go. I was originally like, oh, I'll just weld this to this and then I'll weld that to that. But then I thought about it. I'm like, well, that might actually be more difficult because it might be harder to hold this whole unit and get to tax on this, which is gonna be hard to move around because it's a big guy. So maybe I should tack it on here first where it'll be easier to hold and then tack this on. But if I do that, there's nothing good to hold this up. So anyway, basically the moral of the story is you gotta kind of plan this stuff out as best you can. You don't have to, but obviously it'll make your life easier if you plan it out better than if you don't. So I still haven't decided what to do, but when I figure it out, we'll start tacking. All right, I decided to do it this way because it was the easiest to set up for the first one. So it was kind of a tiebreaker otherwise. It helps if you put it on DC when you're gonna weld steel after you weld the aluminum. All right, got that tacked on. Nice tight gaps all around. So now we gotta find our marks on this side. And yeah, try to figure out how to position this and tack it. Pretty elaborate setup. So I've got it sitting on two magnets up here, which I'm moving around to get it the orientation right. Then I've got a magnet down here, which is a little too small, so I used a piece of metal as a spacer, and now we're good. I just gotta reach all the way over here and tack it without disturbing it. Wish me luck. We got it done. Hopefully it fits. Well, there she is. I mean, I got the clocking as close as I could get it, holding it up that way. It looked pretty close, you know. I know it wasn't exactly perfect even when I marked it, so really the only thing left to it is to test fit it and see if everything will wind back up. Wish me luck. I don't remember how this thing freaking slides up here. Oh, there we go. All right, well, it fit. It was a little bit of a struggle, mainly because of this flange. It's like the flange, the holes are a little bit off. But overall, it went on. I didn't bolt it in, but I mean, all of the studs are into the turbo. It's an equal gap front to back. These are flush, both of these flanges. So, I mean, I'd call that good, I guess. I'm gonna pull it out, weld it, and then try to install it, and we'll see if it is indeed good. I would say wish me luck, but I've said that like 5 times so far. So I won't even bug you guys about it. Okay, Now the fun begins of trying to position this thing in a way where I can weld it. So we can do the other side real quick and then deal with that. Where TIG welding gets tricky, but we have a solution. I have another torch. So this is the torch I normally use. This is actually a pretty small torch. It's a number 9, so it's smaller than your average 17 torch. Anyway, it's smaller. It's water cooled, which is what allows it to be so small, and it can run up to 250 amps. This is a micro torch, well, borderline micro torch, CK80. Anyway, it's real small, and I've got this real small gas lens kit on it, and I built this setup to run on this welder. So for tacking stuff like this on the car, but I haven't used it yet because I still need to get another bottle for that cart of straight argon. So we're gonna try it here. Should easily, oh yeah, it'll easily get us in where we need to go. So let's see how she does. This little guy welds pretty good. We still got more to go, but using you guys as a rest. Solid. Hopefully this thing doesn't fall on me. Wish me luck. I gotta stop asking you guys for luck. All right, we got that all welded up. I went to reposition it and realized I was done. I thought I had a lot more to go. Not the prettiest weld I've ever done on stainless. It seems like every time I try to do like old heat cycled stainless, you never get those nice colors. That only seems to work on new stuff. But either way, it's welded all the way around. Super solid. Really, really happy with this little torch, man. It's real light in the hand. Feels like a very fine instrument. I enjoyed it. So anyway, that's done. Let's reinstall it. Hopefully it still fits and bolt it back up, and then we can move on to the rest of the exhaust, making this thing actually sound good. Oh, okay. Let's hope the turbo bolts go smoothly. Well, everything went back together smoothly. All the bolts are tight, the manifold, the turbo, everything seems to be good. So as far as the fix goes, I think we're good. I want to test it though. So let's fire it up and see if we still got a really loud exhaust leak. Well, started it back up. The exhaust leak where we put the flex joint in is obviously gone. However, on the turbo flange, I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it. Anyway, there's a bolt there and a bolt there. Right in between those two bolts, we have a small leak. So that likely means that the flange on the turbo or the flange on the uppipe deal is warped. I'm not 100% sure which. I've cranked down on the bolts and it's still there. You can feel it with your hand. So I'm gonna pull it back apart and see if I can see anything noticeably wrong with either of them and go from there. Got it back off and I don't see any noticeable signs of leaking. I'm gonna clean this flange up. I clean these studs up. They're a little rusty from being heat cycled, just in case they're catching on the edge of the hole or something. I'm gonna copper spray the exhaust gasket and put some grease on these and try again before I resort to other options. Oh, I reinstalled it for the second time. And we still got a leak in the exact same spot. It's right here, right between these two bolts, because there's a bolt there and a bolt there. And it is right in the center. It's so weird. You know, that's the shortest distance between bolts. There's another bolt that's like way back there. Fine. The shortest distance between two bolts is where it leaks. Don't make no sense, but I don't know. We're gonna have to deal with that later. For now, I'm gonna move on to the muffler and all that stuff because I really wanna get that done. And if I keep fiddling with this, I'll never get to that. what we need to do is figure out where we want our muffler. We're gonna have to cut and then build from there. I really like the tip to actually be out like that, but then we gotta cut this area some to bring it up a little bit so it's not hanging down so well. I mean, that's pretty stealth and it ends up perfect with the bumper. It's not hot boy and sticking out, but that's definitely the cleanest way to do it. You're real easy to make two hangers too, prep. Man, that looks so much better. So much better than that stupid pie cut thing I had. So with the muffler up in place, we need to kind of figure out how we need to chop this. So I'm basically just gonna cut this off to start and then go from there. So this is still gonna be too long, but it'll give us kind of an idea. I might have to cut like here, you know, and then pull in the short mid or something, but I wanna kind of try to get this piece up in there and get a better idea before I cut more. Cause it's like where the muffler needs to go ends up right in the bend of the 45. So I think we'll cut it here in the middle of this and then try to bridge back to it. Okay, so we've got our muffler positioned. We've got this part of the exhaust. We just got to figure out if we can easily get from here to here or if we need to go even further. You know, that is kind of a weird because it's almost like it needs to curve this way and then back this way. So I don't know, we'll start playing with some stuff and see if we can make it work. So the first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and put this flex joint in right here. It's kind of a good spot, it's right past this V-band and it'll give us a lot of flexibility down here, especially once this is all connected. We can kind of get it exactly where we want if we need to. And then that should make it a little easier to bridge this gap from here to here because we'll have some wiggle room. So I'm gonna do that first. All right, we got the flex joint tacked in position and you can see how much like we can do a lot back here now because of that flex joint. Now we just gotta get this piece. This is the last piece. It's gonna be the hardest one, but it's the last one. Just see what we can do. Well, would you look at that? We got kind of lucky because the exhaust piece fits in the muffler. So I have a lot more leeway that way. And then with the flex joint too, I kind of do whatever I need to get it where I need it. I do kind of want it to be a little higher, so I might try to tinker with it some more, but we're about ready to just tack it, so that's exciting. All right, I modified it a little more to get it to tuck up a little higher. I think this is about as good as it's gonna get. The fit up's really good. The angle of this, the location of everything, all seems pretty solid, so I had to double up my ground leads. I have 25 foot torch leads for this welder, but I never got a 25 foot ground, so I got one ground to another ground. Hopefully it works right. I think it will. But anyway, yeah, I'm gonna tack this stuff up in the car. We need to do these two, get the hangers in, and then we can pull it out and weld it all out.
Just the settings are not right.
Looks not bad.
Yeah. No, just the settings for like full kill mode, or I guess I probably just don't really use.
All right, well, she's officially hanging on her own. So one thing I do wanna do, it is low. I plan to redo this kind of section, just working with what I had. I couldn't really get it to tuck up any higher because I don't have the pieces to really redo starting from that flex joint, which is how I need to do it. But anyway, I'm gonna lower it down and just make sure it's not like touching the ground. And if it's not, then we're good to go. We'll pull it off, weld it out. If it is, then we'll have to reassess the situation.
That's really not that bad. We got a solid 3 inches to it. That's the car at static ride height. Sure, she's all the way down.
Yeah, that should honestly be fine. If it's a problem, we'll fix it, but it's already tacked together. And I just wanted it to sound right, so let's pull it off, weld it out. All right, I got both of the hangers welded out. I always weld those out first when I'm doing something like this because they get banged around a lot and they're like often what's, you know, holding the exhaust up. So with only a couple little tacks on there, I feel like it'd be easy to break them off. So I weld those out, and then now we've just got 1, 2, 3, 4 joints. Just 4 joints. So trying to hammer this out quick, get it back on the car because I'm really excited to see how it sounds. I feel like it is going to sound a lot better. So let's get to it. All right, we got it all welded up. Come on, focus. I feel like I can never focus on focus. Anyway, came out pretty nice, especially where it was stainless. This is definitely like mild steel. They must have called it stainless because this mesh is stainless. But I mean, it welded okay. Didn't come out spectacular, but not terrible either. But anyway, it's all welded up, pretty much cooled down. So I'm gonna go throw it on the car, see how it fits. Before we drop her down, I'll give you guys a quick look at her underneath. Like I said, it does hang a little low, but we still got plenty of clearance. If it's a problem, we'll fix it later. It's gonna require ordering some stuff and basically redoing it from here because things are in a different spot than when I made it with the straight pipe. So anyway, yeah, overall, looks solid. No complaints. So let's drop her down and see what she sounds like. All right, moment of truth time. That tip is really stealthily tucked up in there. I really just wanted to make sure I kept the muffler where all the heat shielding was, and you know, keeps it from looking too ricey. Let's try it out. Wow, that's quiet. Gotta let it idle down and hear it, and then we'll rev it. So much better. This is definitely not a car that I wanted to be obnoxiously loud. I'm used to turbo cars being pretty quiet still, even with straight pipe. But this thing straight piped is horrible. I put the resonator in it. Better, still horrible. Now, nice and quiet. I'll give you guys a rev, and then we'll go take it for a rip and get some real exhaust noise. Car is definitely not running 100% because we have that massive exhaust leak up at the turbo that we'll have to take care of, but I still want to go take it for a rip and just kind of see how it sounds cruising and on throttle and in boost. So let's do it. It is the perfect day to take this thing for a cruise. It's so nice out. It's like 60, maybe 50 something. Perfect. We got the sound cam set up now, so we're gonna see what this thing sounds like. Hopefully the GoPro doesn't fall off. loud. That's gonna be it for this video. Subaru is kind of back up and running. I guess it's not officially because we got to fix the other gasket, but sounds way better now. Finally has a muffler on it, and yeah, like I said, I really like this car. I'm excited to do more with it. We'll get her fixed up. Just one of those things, man. We got to get started on the Cummins build. I'm trying to knock out the last little lingering projects like on this and the Miata before I dive into it, because I know once I dive in, I'm in. Plus, you know, having to move two giant trucks around is going to be a little bit of a pain. So I want to try to put them somewhere and keep them there. So anyway, see you guys then. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Goodbye.